Hello there, YouTube, and welcome to this scrim that I'm going to be casting with my good buddy Beard today. This is BkS.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm already introducing. This is BkS, and today they're fighting against a Wappaw, two clans in the North American Warband community. What's up, Beard?
Oh, hi.
So
I will also be recording this.
Yeah, and I'll leave links to Beard's channel, because he finally has a channel. Yeah!
Yeah, and y'all should subscribe to me too, because my channel's better than Sal's. Not really, but I'm working on.
No.
Alright, I don't even know if this is live. Do you know if this is live?
I think this is live, because they reset a, Oh, look at that. Pierce gets a kill on Vanadar, and God's Knight kills Pierce. So,
there we go.
Decrease the
numbers. That's a lot of failure right there.
So what do we know about these two teams here?
Wappaw, really known for its good teamwork over individual player skill. Like, you're just watching that Strango and that other Wappaw just beating down on peers.
Mm-hmm.
They're good with all pikes, good with cav coordination, good with lots of stuff. BkS, known for being the best clan in the North American community, good for just all-around teamwork, plus just, you know, being good.
Mm-hmm. They have individuals, and they've got the teamwork. God's Knight there killed two people on his own team, but then he killed two other people, so he sort of paid for himself. And now, Raid, fighting Strango, but Tyrion wrapping it up with a cav, and he's just gonna end God's Knight. So first round to BKS, as I like to call them.
Yeah!
Alright, so BkS supposedly leaving the community after a couple more scrims. They've got, what are they rolling with? Four archers and three cav?
I think.
Probably. With
a lot of infantry and cav. Three infantry, four cav, I believe. No crossbows, which is surprising. Mm-hmm. Generally, Wappaw likes to have crossbows too, but
they all have decent armor, though, so it looks like they, they're going for the brute approach, where they're just going to get on top of the BkS archers, but I mean, with four archers, it's going to be kind of hard to do that, and you can see now a shield has been broken.
Yeah, Cav's just swooping in there, taking advantage of the fact that the infantry's in the open. I mean, the Wappaw Cav is still hovering around trying to defend, and but yeah, that guy without a shield just getting picked apart.
Yeah, BkS does this very well, where they seem to just be at the right place at the right time. I don't know if it's coordinated or if they just work together really nicely because they've been playing together for a long time.
Probably a little bit of both.
That almost a perfect round with only Raid dying.
Raid is BkS's fearless leader, Raid. By the way.
Alright, so
hey, we got two BkS left here.
Oh crap, what happened to the BkS cavalry?
Got torn apart. Well, Pa went mostly cav, so.
Oh, I see. They just attacked the cav and ignored the archer, I guess?
Well, no, they attacked the archers.
Mm.
Knocked them out very efficiently. And
it's a very good approach. They're using that Swadian Great Lance to good effect. And you can see that they have the heavy horses as well.
Yeah.
There goes
Tyrion going down there. Looks like we got Vanidar left alive.
I don't think he even has a lance.
Nah, Vanidar doesn't like lances.
Gonna try to
dehorsing now, taking it on foot, and Pi using their world famous spear tactics there, getting the kill.
Yep. Very different approaches to the game and how they play it on both teams, but they both have really good teamwork, I think.
It looks like BkS. Tarn didn't spawn yet. They still got three cav, three archers. See what happens when Harn spawns.
Hmm. So Wappaw's still going with
Harness another archer, by the looks of it.
This is curious on BKS's side.
Yeah, I would have thought they would have went all cav or something to try and counter the Wappaw cav, but...
So how many cav do they currently have?
Three,
looks like. Got Tyrion.
Yeah, they got 3 cav, 4 archers.
Oh no, they have Raid, Harn, and Vanadar on horseback. As well as Tyrion. They've got 4 cav and 3 archers actually, and here comes the main fight. Oof, Raid coming in behind and hitting Mafioso.
Yeah.
You see, very hectic here, and it looks like the teams are just clashing. While the BKS archers are just trying to shoot into the fight, maybe another BKS kill here. Raid goes down to God's Knight.
Yeah. God's Knight doing pretty good. 4-2, leading the scoreboard. Oh. Double pass scoreboard.
As you can see there, African barely escaped a great lance. Just pulled his sword out and quickly shot him. And look at this here, when African is like endangered, the two cav sort of come in and cover a retreat. He just runs away, and then the cav sort of do their job, you know.
Effective cav archer. Take a few hits there, but I don't think it'll matter that much.
Ooh,
Harn going down. We'll pile all pike tactic there. Very nice, very nice.
Oh.
And Tyrion.
Saving African again. I guess vulnerability creates more vulnerability. So like when a BKS archer is sort of like in the open and a cav wants to go kill him, if another BKS member can pick up on that, sort of like what just happened in front of you, he just like comes in and cleans up real quickly.
Oh, looks like Tyrion found another horse.
Try to go for the couch. And Vanadar there. Excellent range control. Just barely getting that head off pawn. It's 3-1 BKS.
Yeah. I have no clue what they're playing to, do you?
Nope.
Probably 5.
4 cav, 3 archers on one side, 4 cav, and 5 cav appears on Wappaw's side here. It's all cav for Wappaw.
They're going for that cav rush again.
Yeah, they're going for that cav advantage.
For him once.
They do have great lances, but you can see now Vanadar just running away with his cursor. Running away with his cursor, and he is just using darts. Not going to be very effective against horses, but they can bring them down to the point where he can, you know, stop them like that and maybe get a sword slash on it and dehorse other cav. Which is what Vanadar seems to do the most, but if he misses his darts sort of like that, he's in big trouble.
Yeah. We got there, Vanadar's being heavily pursued by Wappaw cav. Raid just swoops in, takes down one of their horse. Excellent teamwork there.
Oh, Raid gets taken down in a very nice move, and Vanadar's horse killed, and now he's probably gonna get horse banged in a minute.
Yeah, Wappaw's just swooping in there, taking advantage of that.
Wow.
He's not going down without a fight, though. He's getting bumped, but he's still in
there. Where is the BKS team?
Obviously not there.
He took a horse down with him, so...
Eh, it's good.
Now BKS is in a little bit of trouble here. You can see the calf fight happening far away from the archers. And they have Harn and Tyrion left on horseback, and you can see now obviously trying to draw the enemy cav back to the BKS cav, the BKS archers.
I'm not sure why the cav insisted on fighting their cav so much, it just ended out badly.
Yeah, I think it might have been a little bit of an overconfidence over there, and they probably didn't expect the all cav teams. Once they realized maybe that there was too many cav, they were like, just pull out.
Alright, we got the BkS Archer squadron here moving up, getting a little closer.
Oh, look at that.
Look at that perfect roleplay firing line right there. Look at it. Just look at it. It's beautiful.
There are the three musketeers.
Alright, looks like the three archers are all we got left here on the BkS side.
Facial man hair is mandatory, it appears, except for last guy. It's Search.
Search.
I rarely see Search.
Yeah, he's not one of the more active ones. Alright. Just shooting people.
And it's just gonna be here in a minute when the infantry close in.
And then the cav will come up from behind. BkS, yep. They're doing a great job dehorsing while they can, but the infantry are here, not much they can do. The cav are just swooping in, picking them off one by one. Ghost Piers, last stand.
3-2 to BkS. Wappaw making a good comeback, I think, in that round, going for the all-cav rush. It worked pretty well, but you can see this time that they didn't actually go for the archers. They sort of just...
Yeah.
Went for the cav, which I think is a smarter thing actually, because if you can isolate the cav sort of far away from the archers, you can get kills without sacrificing any of your horses. But at this stage, Wappaw seems to have, a good number of heavy cav, a fast cav with coursers, and they do have, I think, one hunter. So they do have good vitality for their horses.
Alright, we got BkS rolling 4 cav, 3 archers. I think that's what they did last round too. What is Wappaw doing again?
Wappaw is all cav as well.
All cav again.
Mm-hmm.
See how this works out for him.
Yeah, I mean, they have the cavalry advantage. They're eating Swadia, I think, the best way that they can, because I think the reason they're not picking any crossbows up is because they know that they will be outshot by the BkS archers. African and Piers are both really good shots. I mean, Wappaw does have some good shots as well, but I don't see LeGraf anywhere, and he's probably their best shooter. So, they're probably going for the more brute force approach, which worked good now for 2 rounds for them, so let's see how it plays out this round.
Alright. Looks like BkS Cav not being as aggressive this time. Really waiting for the archer support. Trying to use more coordination. Not as overconfident. Yeah, as you can see, the archers, the three musketeers, just chilling out again, shooting. While the cav hover nearby.
You can see that the BkS cavalry is going in circles, sort of around their archers. Which makes it super easy for their archers to target a cav that's on their tail. So like when Tyrion's running away and, you know, there's a slower horse behind him, it's sort of easy to pick off that horse because it's going to maintain that straightness, you know. It's not going to be trying to dodge your arrows as much.
Right. See what Wappaw's doing. Wappaw's really scared to get in there. They might be waiting for Master of the Field. It's very possible.
Yeah, it could be a smart thing, actually, because they have more men on the Master. Because BkS has archers, and they don't. God's Knight rocking the Great Helm.
Let me see.
He's like, standard everything with a Great Lance and a Great Helm. It's like, yeah.
Yeah, don't mess. I got a Great Helm.
That's swag.
He also has good boots.
Mm-hmm. You can see BkS
boots
here.
Are important for cav.
Maybe trying to go away from the trees to maybe draw the Wappaw cav in a little bit. Or maybe just get better shots.
Yeah. I'm fairly certain this round is going to come down to Master. Yep,
and there
Master. It is.
And it's actually pretty close to the BkS group, but Wappaw already has men on it.
Right, yeah. I got a feeling Wappaw's cab is just gonna sweep in, hit the BkS archers from behind if given a chance.
can see they're already putting the flag up. BkS not making an active attempt here to actually get on the flag there, so they're more worried about their archer staying alive. There goes African. Pierce gets a headshot. And as long as the flag is going up for Wappaw, this could be good. But you can see now Harn closing in with Tyrion and Vanadar at the same time. And they're cleaning up the flag area, but the flag is still going up. They need to get on foot.
Alright, Salted Slug, he's down. He's the one who's defending the flag.
And there he goes.
Excellent work there by Tyrion. Tyrion's getting on that flag. Yeah. Not going to let BkS have it. Or
you can see now Wappaw
have it, I should say.
BkS
not willing to give up. BkS does have a numbers advantage here.
Indeed. And there goes a horse.
And there goes a rider. There's the rider. Looks like BkS is gonna claim this round.
See the flag now in BkS's favor.
Wappaw though, still not willing to give up. They're fighting hard for that flag.
Yeah, they probably should have one person dismount and the other person fight off the cav. But what they're doing now isn't helping much, and there's gonna be 40 seconds left. There goes down one of the horses. And looks like the other one, yes, there it goes.
Yep, and it's over.
Yeah, it's over.
Yep, there you go.
Very close rounds, actually, here. You'd expect, you'd expect nothing less from both these clans.
Yeah, Wappaw is known for its excellence on random planes.
Yeah, it's sort of like their trump card, I feel, sometimes. They're going again with the all-cav mix. Looks like they feel that that's working out well for them.
And it kind of is. I mean, that last round was close.
Mm-hmm.
Just feel if they could have gotten the archers down quicker before they shot so many horses, it might have worked out better.
Yeah, I don't know. I think they did an okay job with taking care of the archers. I mean, it was three archers at one tree. That's a very dangerous place to go to when you're a horse. But
even
they managed
for the Wappaws.
Yeah, but they managed to go in there and, you know, clean it up. They did lose a good number of men, but if they left a single archer surviving, that flag fight would have been so much less dramatic. The archer would have just weighed in too much.
Alright, looks like one Wappaw down. Nice couch there by BkS Cav, not really sure who. But Pierce getting the kill.
There goes African, one archer down.
Looks like Wappaw's taking an archer heavy, hit the archers, get them down, approach again. Which is what they did one time and it worked very well. BkS is down to one archer.
I think what Wappaw's trying to do is fight on top of the archers so that if they do get dismounted.
Oh, raid T-Kang Vanadar. That ain't good.
Vanadar's probably like, dude, what the fuck, man? What the fuck?
I can hear it now.
So yeah, as I was saying, Wappaw fighting the calf fight on top of the archers in that incident. And you saw there that as the BKS were actually successful in dismounting some Wappaw, Wappaw just continued on the archers. Oh, and Salted Slug drops here. So just Tyrion left against, what, four people?
Look at Tyrion, score them.
Tyrion for MVP of clan?
Yeah, tell me, like I said before, I think while you were away, Tyrion's probably one of BKS's best members.
He's probably the best member at this stage, I feel. But maybe because he plays, I still see him around sometimes. I haven't seen the other members playing the game with their regular aliases for a long time.
Yeah, they only really show up for scrims. Which is probably why.
Maybe they play under aliases, I don't know.
I don't know either.
So same setup.
BkS is picking up another archer and two infantry. BkS using infantry on random planes? This is unheard of. Like, they never do this.
I think they've realized that their archers just can't survive cav spam. As I said around before, when the cav fight happens right on top of the archers, when the infantry gets dismounted, when the cav gets dismounted and becomes infantry, it's sort of hard for the cav to protect the archers as well. But it looks like now they've got four archers, as you said, and two infantry, so they're sort of like going to split up in two teams, maybe.
Yeah. Well, Pa's still cav heavy. Looks like the Wappaw cav are just circling here. Waiting for an opportunity to strike. Probably a little bit intimidated now by the mob of BKS. But thinking Wappaw might be smart enough not to attack that clump and just wait for Master, hope it's in an advantageous position. Just outmaneuver him there.
Yeah, it will be a good idea for Wappaw to sort of hold back here. They don't have any infantry of their own. Attacking that group of four archers and two infantry with a horse, no matter how many horses you have, that's a tough place to be.
Yeah, I would not want to rush that as cap, especially since so many of them have coursers. Yeah, it's gonna be a good fight.
See Benadar here trying to pull some horses with him. But, not particularly working.
Yeah, some of them have arrows in them, but...
Now, BKS have cover in their position, but they also sort of won't be able to see, a cav come in, from that little hilled area.
Right.
But I think maybe that's why they've chosen this position. You can see they see everything around them except that one area, so it's really easy for them to focus on, you know... a horse coming in from that area, because, you know, there's just one place that horse is going to be coming from.
Maybe... Oh, Pierce getting a kill there.
They're sort of just, like, jumping around.
Anyone who's watching my video right now and looking at my camera, I'm trying to glitch under the map here to see where Master's going to spawn. It looks like it's going to spawn... You can see that little flag there, like, right in a position that's pretty good for BKS, actually, I believe. Let me find some BKSs.
There it is.
And looks like my master prediction was wrong. Maybe that trick doesn't work. Dang it, X!
It's quite far away from BKS, actually. If Wappaw gets on it in mass, it might be...
BKS, though, you know, shaking off that fatness, really running it. They're trying, Wappaw trying to get Cav to go and slow down the advance.
Oh,
it's not working too well. BKS just cleaning up here. But, you know, Wappaw Cav still taking down a few. Action's pretty intense here.
This just went one way here. That went downhill for Wappaw really quickly. There it goes. That's why you can't attack an infantry group with archers, with four archers and two infantry mixed in, when you got people like Poors. And African is 0-5. Get some kills, son.
Really?
So look at this. Wappaw is going to respond to the change in tactics, and they're going to bring up three infantry to the field. One of them is turtling up in Leonidas manner. Leonidas
Not
himself.
Leonidas.
Two of them are turtling up in Leonidas manner.
Not Leonidas, Nick Dean.
Nick Dean. Nick Dean the turtle.
Nick Dean, yes.
I haven't seen him in a long time.
No. Guy used to be a really good duelist, but then I beat him. True story.
So BKS, or BAS, or what have you, is now running... same thing, but you can see all their dudes are in the same armor. This could be kind of confusing for a cav when you're coming in at fast speeds. When there's like a big mob of stuff happening.
Like, yeah, they all look alike, yeah. Too. You know, we got a lot of bald people. Some hairy people.
Cool. Alright. So, Wappaw now, bringing a lot of shields, and they're all pikes, and look at this, Vanadar's dead. He's fucked.
Oh, yeah.
You don't attack. You don't attack that, bro. You don't attack three all pikes with your horse without a lance or, you know.
Yeah. Well, what's gonna happen here? I don't care who you are.
What's gonna happen in the fight here? You can see Tyrion now pushing up, trying to protect the blob.
Yeah, the Wappaw have just come from all angles. That's what they're good at doing. Why they always pick random planes? Because they let their infantry come in and then just, you know, let their cavs swoop in.
But notice that BkS the
doing a great job defending, though.
Yeah, the Wappaw
just tearing
isolated.
It off. What a shot.
Piers saving BkS ass that round. Wappaw yes. Became too isolated way too fast. And again,
let's see what Wappaw's doing this time.
Same tactic for Wappaw. I think this is the last round.
Looks like they're picking up another infantry, though.
Ah, indeed they are. BkS rolling still with the same. This is the first time I personally have seen BkS not go with the archer cav approach on this map. I mean, Wappaw has some excellent cavalry. Usually BkS has the cavalry advantage when they're playing against other clans, but Wappaw has some really good cav. They can play cav really well. But BkS just, you know, at one point realized maybe we don't have to fight them so hard over the cav fight. Let's do it in another way. And it's worked for them. Let's see what the Wappaw approach will bring them today.
Looks like they're trying to rush the archer mob again.
Mm-hmm.
Thanadar still skirmishing, trying to get... I see what he's doing there, Sal. He's trying to get the backs towards the archers.
Yep, he's trying to turn them around.
But it's not working so good.
He's just gonna come in here.
Infantry are coming in. Cav following.
What Wappaw needs to do is not get separated and gang up on them. So like you can see here. Oof. What a kill by Pierce.
Yeah, Pierce is tearing it up.
And now in this type of situation, BkS has the total advantage. As you saw, they're just gonna skirmish and pull back.
Yeah. Classic archer crossfire, pretty hard to beat. Rain, get the game-winning kill there.
There it goes. That is the first half of the match. Hope you guys enjoyed the little bit of coverage. So let's see what sort of nature the next one is gonna have.